Hello from Gardening at Duenza here in Ireland, and this is a quick follow-up orchid video on the last one where I showed you a variety of my plants that were actually in flower or coming into flower. And since that video, a couple of them have actually come into flower, so I just wanted to share them with you before they go over or something like that. So let's have a look at these orchids. Right, just before we start, to let you know that I've brought the orchids out here to the garden to make the video, just so that I can have better light. And you know, in Ireland it's always a thing looking for the best light, and it can be tricky. So anyway, I've brought these plants out here. It's a little bit windy today. I hope my stirbic doesn't break, but we'll persevere anyway. Now, the first one I want to share with you is this fantastic Oncidium, formerly known as Odontoglossum, and this one, the cultivar name is Stirbic Red, and isn't it an absolute gem? Now, there are some people out there who say they don't like Oncidiums, and my answer to that is, what is wrong with you? How can you not absolutely love these fantastic flowers? They are so gorgeous, all those, you know, tiger-like markings on the petals, and then the complexity at the center of the lip. It's a bit blowy here today for showing that, but there's yellow and all kinds of beautiful things going on. And this plant has gifted me with two spikes this year, which I'm completely delighted with. Now, this is a, well, it's a hybrid Oncidium that is generally available, but this one came to me via Inca Orchids, and this label you will see in various garden centers or nurseries wherever you are, and it's a Dutch company that produces a variety of beautiful hybrids, and so look out for that, and perhaps you'll find a Stirbic Red to grace your collection with as well. So I am delighted with that. But the other ones I also want to show you are this Phalaenopsis, which is leaning dangerously, okay, and this is Elegance Peach, also a hybrid, which I picked up at a supermarket, I believe, some years ago, and it really is a very, very pretty flower, as you can see. Lots of spots and markings going on there that, well, it will enthrall you. You'll spend a lot of time just looking at the various markings. Now, I don't have a whole lot of buds. I don't have a large number of buds, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that'll do me. It's good. Good, good, good. Okay, now, this next one. Ah, this is a gem of a Phalaenopsis, and it's a primary cross between two species, one of which is Corninja and the other is Sumatra, and I'll put the labels up on the screen. It's just easier than trying to squint at them here. But it's a first flowering for this particular plant, and I just moved this one out of the way, and it has gifted me with this fabulous flower. Now, it isn't what I expected. I didn't expect it to be full purple, but this is the thing, when you're not dealing with a cultivar, you're dealing with a cross. So I actually have two plants in the one pot here, and this one has given me all purple flowers, but perhaps this second plant over here is going to have different colored flowers, so that'll be quite interesting to see. And it smells absolutely divine. I'm going to give it a sniff now. Very floral. Really, really, really floral, sweet, gorgeous scent. Anyway, I highly recommend it. Now, for anybody whose taste extends to shop-bought Phalaenopsis, you may be slightly disappointed by this well, primary cross flower that is just held as a single flower on a plant like this. But do you know what? Like, for anybody who's a proper connoisseur, like I guess most of you are, you're going to appreciate how gorgeous that is and how worthy that one flower is. I think sometimes when you just have one flower to look at, you appreciate it all the more, and yeah, and enjoy it all the more. So that's absolutely gorgeous. Okay, and I guess the last thing I want to share with you, it's kind of a double story. So here we have my Phalaenopsis equestris in full flower, a species miniature orchid that has deigned to give me a spike with many flowers on it, and it's a sister plant to I have two of them basically, and the other one has flowered several times before, but this one decided to be reluctant until now, so I'm very pleased to have it in flower. But what I really wanted to tell you about was that I also have the orange version of this Phalaenopsis equestris in the form of this plant here, and if we look in closely there, you can see that I have a spike coming. So this is the orange form, and it was given to me by Alberto, who used to have an orchid channel, an excellent orchid channel, and I do wish he would he would make videos again. But this will be a first flowering for this particular Phalaenopsis equestris, the orange variety, and I'd be very delighted to see what those flowers look like when they come out. Okay, so this was my orchid update, and I'm going to have to wrap this up now because I really don't want the wind to break these glorious spikes on my Sturbic, and I feel it might if I stay out here much longer. But thank you very much for watching, and if orchids are your particular passion, then do check back again soon to see, well, lots more orchid videos, and there will certainly be lots more from me going into autumn when there's less to do in the garden and my focus returns to houseplants and orchids in particular. So yeah, look out for that. Thanks very much for watching, and that's all for now. Bye.